I feel like my job as a non-biased person who covers the Cleveland Browns, and I'm starting to get a little biased, I got to be honest, because we have, me and Chris, have been covering the Browns here on Sports Talk Extra since before the season started, since June. In fact, it's the Browns that had this channel just take off in the beginning. That was the first big video that popped. And so we are so thankful forever to the Cleveland Browns fans. And we mostly do Browns and Texans content on this now, but it allows us to bring you Brownies videos almost every single day. So we want to be your go-to source for that. But I feel like my job has been, since the season ended very abruptly in a way that nobody expected, is almost like damage control, to remind Browns fans, like, it's good. Right? And so I'm just here to tell you again, it's good. And I got some stuff that proves it for you. All right? I'm just going to talk about it. Here he is. All right? Myles Garrett wins the 23-24 NFL Defensive Player of the Year at the NFL Honors. Like, the big one. He already won the AP Defensive Player of the Year. Now he's won the NFL Honors Defensive Player of the Year. I need it to be known that this is a guy that you have locked up. All right? He is locked up. He is under contract. Are you paying him heavily for what he's done? Yes, you are. All right? And that's okay. This is a guy who had 15 sacks this year. This is based on PFF stats, by the way. All right? Sometimes their sack numbers are a little off. 15 sacks, 57 hurries, 14 additional hits for a total of 86 pressures. That's insane. That is insane. That is 4.5 a game. That is a game wrecker. That is a game changer. And that is a guy that you will continue to have on your team who is just an absolute freak. All right. He is the best player in the NFL on that side of the ball. He is on your team. Also at the NFL Honors, you had your head coach win Coach of the Year. Coach of the Year. So he wins Coach of the Year in, by the way, just a crazy fashion. All right. And this is tough. The three teams that we cover most, all right, are the Lions with our original channel, Sports Talk Detroit. Okay. That's what is our original bread and butter. And then we started this channel, Sports Talk Extra, and that's gone to, like I said, mostly Browns and Texans. So the three teams that we cover finished 1, 2, and 3 in Coach of the Year award race. And you can make an argument any way you want on this. If I'm on the Lions channel, and I do believe this, and I'm arguing for Dan Campbell to win Coach of the Year, and he wasn't even close. Like, he wasn't even close. And so I'm talking on that channel about, like, how is he not even close to Stefanski and to D'Amico Ryans? But then I can make the argument, if I'm on the Texans channel, that D'Amico Ryans, based on doing it with a rookie quarterback, as a first-year head coach making the playoffs, and then, yes, unfortunately, for the listeners of this channel, beating the Browns in the playoffs, I can make a very easy argument that it's D'Amico Ryans. And then I can just as easily make an argument for Kevin Stefanski. I can talk about how he has taken this team that is cap-strapped, that had more injuries than I've ever seen on an NFL football team in my life, and still had that thing purring like a kitten, all right, without a starting quarterback for the majority of the season. And you went 11-6 and made the playoffs in what is arguably the single hardest division in football. And so I can very easily make the argument for all of them. But here's the truth. The fact that you have the Coach of the Year, the fact that you have the Defensive Player of the Year, and then you retain your defensive coordinator, you retain the vast majority of your defensive staff, and then you go out and you find a new tight ends coach. You go out and you get a new running backs coach. All right? Deuce Staley, by the way. You go out and you get a new offensive coordinator who used to play quarterback for you in Ken Dorsey, but also, oh, just, you know, led a top three offense in his year and a half at Buffalo. No big deal, right? And you get these guys that are there to help and to make the team better. You go out and get a new offensive line coach. I mean, it's going well. And so while you are cap strapped, while you're not going to be making a lot of noise in free agency, and you're going to have to kind of shop on the fringes here, also it should be known and it should be said that you have arguably the best coaching staff in the NFL. If not the best, it's a top 3 to 5. For sure. Coaching staff in the NFL. You have the best defensive player in the NFL. You have some very solid pieces on the offensive line. And you can be ready to have a defense that's going to be phenomenal. And guess what? Hopefully you just unlock the key to what would be a great season for Deshaun Watson by bringing in new coaches to help his progression. So yes, I feel like sometimes my job here is to go and remind all Browns fans that don't worry, the sky is not falling. You've had sustained success and you will continue to. The way in which your cap situation is. You know who has that same cap situation based on the way they run their cap every year? The Saints. Okay? And when they had a good coach, it worked just fine for them. All right? They're not the only team who runs it that way. Sometimes the Ravens run it that way. All right? The Steelers can run it that way at times. There are a lot of good teams that seem to run in the negative often, but they move money around, they change contracts, they restructure, and it allows them to go and get the players that they need to get, and then they draft well. And by the way, sometimes drafting well is because you have a good GM. And I think Barry's a good GM. But sometimes it looks like you draft well because you have a coach that knows how to utilize those draft picks. You have a coach and a GM that are on the same page. And for the amount of time that they've been together and the success that they're having, even with all the injuries, I think it's safe to say that these two guys understand each other and they understand what they're trying to accomplish with each other. So that all leads to be excited about this offseason. Let's see what you got, because you can go from 11-6. You already are adding your quarterback back. All right, and I'm telling you right now, Deshaun Watson, I know he wasn't playing remarkable, but he's not throwing interceptions also. He's not throwing those interceptions that Flacco threw against the Texans. So it's going to be an upgrade at quarterback. You got to believe that. You are so close to being an elite team, and you never know what can happen. So, all right, thanks for watching. Continue watching here all, what would it be, winter, spring, summer, and into next season. We want to be your spot for Brown content. All right, see you later.